Hi guys, this is Anol, and we are back playing Soviet Union in Castlevania 4. So I've done some thinking, and also I looked into the sorry state of German divisions here. I mean, some are at like 10% strength here due to those pointless and constant attacks. I don't know why they are happening. They really shouldn't have. Paradox, please. But I think the best. Okay, so we won't be able. Like I've done a little bit of math, and really, it doesn't seem like we will be able to use all of the divisions that we have here in not too distant future. So might as well take those panzers and actually send them to Europe and start thinking about offensive operation here in Poland. So we are going to take them and place them here for the time being, and we'll just use those black tanks for this. And another thing, we'll just start working on justifying on all those minor nations around here. To get a nice proper front line against Soviets, against Brits. I guess we can start working on Turkey as well. It would be problematic because they probably have like what? Actually, they don't really have 100 divisions that I assume they will. So let's start working on them. That's fairly expensive political power wise. So. Yeah, but, well, might as well. Need to start somewhere. What else, what else, what else? Well, I don't think we'll... I'm sure about Lithuania. We'll wait with Lithuania, because I believe that will take only a week or so for them to submit to our ultimatum, so we'll leave that be. And, yeah, continue our advance into China, and... Yeah, I think we'll, as soon as we declare war on both Afghanistan, Tibet, and Iran, and I guess Iraq, we will outright declare war on the United States. And, well, okay, let's wait a week and we'll declare both British Raj, I guess, and the United States, just to make sure they all, because I'm not sure if they would actually join allies if we declared on them, and I don't want to risk any more nonsense with faction jumping that's happened in my French campaign, because there were some weird shit going on. Alright, here. Seems like we have been kind of stopped around here to some extent. Let's definitely shorten the front to this. Well, this is problematic. Yes, it is. Okay, let's not do this attack. That doesn't make much sense in to attack into those mountains. Let's move you here. What does make sense is, I think, to take half of our troops and attack this, and the other half of our 60. Tank divisions start like that. The rest of you can more or less wait. And how many divisions are there? Three only. Well, let's capture them anyway. Something like that. How many divisions are? Okay, so it's like, okay, call it off. Seems like we'll be cut off here. Those red infantry divisions should start trickling in as soon as we get more supply going around here. And this whole thing should, as I mentioned earlier, start collapsing due to lack of supplies. Yeah, those they are getting pretty mad, pretty severely beaten up. Wow, you can see them dying. Okay, another preemptive fix of this. Okay, we definitely have too small of an attack line here. Let's get more aggressive about it. Okay. Another naval base, that would be nice if we could. Let's try. Something like that, and well, not sure about. Well, there will be Chinese troops around here, so that almost definitely won't work, since well, Japan is all around their business. Help with this, and well, it would be nice if we could, for example, close all of that. We have a hammer here, but we definitely don't have an anvil or like, well, a moving anvil that could push whatever they have there. So, I mean, actually, that seems like a decent idea, especially since those two specific provinces are fairly easy to capture due to, you know, not being bloody mountains. Let's try to do this. I will. Okay. This way now. I think we'll go this way to get ourselves this river going. So basically, we want something like that. Of course, one division won't be nearly enough, but you instead of helping, try to enlarge this whole thing. This is enough for the time being, I'd say, and you, my friend, should help with that nonsense and continue here. We will redeploy some units from there here as well. Should be well. We have this attack going, so how about we support it for the time being, keep them busy. Possibly make them throw some more units there. This redeployment, and I think we'll unassign them for the time being because they would move somewhere else. Which same goes. Okay, you guys can throw. Let's unassign you as well and redeploy here. Yeah, that should do it. Like six Panzer divisions. If we do it quick, we should be able to. To perhaps close this small pocket here. Oh, yeah. Now this is bloody working with the planes and such. And seems like they have not assigned much in terms of AA coverage here. Or air coverage, really. AA coverage. And we have full control of this one, so. It will be difficult for them to pull out of there being slowed by 50%. One more look at Denmark. Well, they sure are dying here over this, but it's will, I'm afraid, once again be pushed back from there. So just need to keep an eye on that, make sure that they won't be pushed back into a province we don't want them to be. I don't think we'll ever reinforce this. We'll just try to like because there are basically no victory points around here, so this cavalry serves a very good role of well, keeping them busy while we get all the victory points here that may force them to actually capitulate. And yes, there are a lot of divisions there, so let's stop this. Not sure about this. This is weird. Okay, no, that's better. And that's a lot of Japanese troops. Let's unassign you as well and just make you redeploy here. Maybe we'll be able to contain this, not sure. Would be nice. What else? What else? This is going. Well, not really, but I mean. I guess they do have a little bit of victory points here, so there is some supply production, but I would imagine it's not nearly enough to support all of this. Okay, nothing to do there. Afghan sovereignty, very well. Alright, you guys. You guys were supposed to. Okay, if we ordered you to move this way, you will be there in 16 hours. If I order them you to move normally, 2 days, but you will. Yeah, let's just move normally. We've suddenly reinforced quite a lot, and we don't really have any units on the other side of this, but it's looking good for now. This small incursion of ours. How's the supply? Bad. But at least here is decent, so perhaps some infantry units will decide to move there. Let's redeploy some of them. Okay, so. Yeah, it's actually. We need to deal with this thing. Let's do that. You guys are moving there as well, so. Yeah. Redeploy though, yeah. Here you go. Okay, this is interesting. And let's take one more look at our losses. I mean, they lost almost twice what we did. But yeah, not nearly as big of a massacre as there. Not even close, so attacking. Again, they definitely have a disadvantage when it comes to quality of troops and such. Sure, they have their scales up, so they have bonuses because of that, but not as big of a difference as one would hope. Leave one division here to defend and continue here. How many divisions? 4. And those are Japanese ones, so even more, well, more effective ones. They have very few left after that mess. Yeah, they have like 40 divisions or so. But probably decent ones. This will take a while, I guess. We can throw another 5 divisions there, though. I don't think we care enough, but we are more they are dead, more or less, anyway. So let's focus on this. And this, as you can see, is getting... is getting problematic. We should be good. Alright, so improved artillery area upgrades. Another, what, 10% to our soft attack. We could actually start working on the last upgrade of artillery. Not a terrible idea, since, well, a difference in terms of supplies is, resources needed is just one steel. I guess there's some production difference, isn't it? Yeah, 0.5, but, yeah, difference is very noticeable. So there is one option. Another option is, as I mentioned earlier, start working on logistics companies, since we would want to continue with them as well. Here, I don't think we have enough. Well, this is another thing we want to start working on, and I think we'll actually take this since we will need those medium tanks operational fairly shortly. So, and those are expensive things, as you can see here. So, yeah, let's do that, and we'll use this slot for logistics company. Another thing, of course, that we will want, or rather need, is, well, that's not like 100% sure, but I'm pretty worried about synthetic oil refineries. I would have went for them, but we have such limited amounts of civilian factories that I think we are better off trying to conquer Singapore rather than actually trying to get the synthetic refineries in our territory. So, well, we'll see how that goes. You guys try to reach that. Oh, damn it. There you go. Oh, we got some new... okay, we get organization first. Never actually seen that one. Additional reinforced, right? Nice. We already have fast planner, defensive and offensive doctrine. And we are almost at skill 7 due to all the fighting we are doing with Tukhachevsky. And we are halfway towards the logistics wizard. Oh my, that would be amazing. I think that's minus 10% research supply use. And the second one is charismatic, which I honestly don't remember what it's doing. So, well, we'll remind ourselves together. Oh, this is definitely not working. I guess keep them busy if you really want. Not sure what's about this attack though, like, really. How about a smaller breakthrough here? You guys redeploy there again. There. Okay, that went... This is relying very much, isn't it? They haven't even entered combat yet. Let's actually send one there. It's through the river, so like this. And those, okay, so basically all of you are going there, and half of you are going through here. And try to push. Oh, this is another... like angle we can try to exploit, so if there won't be much in terms of resistance. I wonder how many troops are here, but seeing... well, actually they have quite a lot here. In some places. This is another issue, like with those things. The lack of attack order when things like that happen. So unless you give them a push, that will never end. All right, and let's I'm not gonna, like, I should manage those two front lines long ago, but I just leave them as they are, and the reorganization would have been much more annoying. Look at that, like, they will never fucking catch up. Well, actually, that was going fairly well. We captured another... one more thing. How is the resistance? We don't have much, or anything, but that will be a problem here. I think it's time to start requesting territory, especially around Beijing. From the Soviets, maybe? From the... from the Mongolia. How is it in terms of resources? Oh right, there are no resources. I was like, I'm pretty sure I switched them up, but nope, no resources. Just, well, there are of course some dockyards and factories, but we'll need to polish it. I know what, well, we want to take it anyway, so. Ask for control of the state. Hopefully they will accept. Alright, actually, should have asked for that one as well. We need to wait. Oh, just one day. Well, for now, we have enough divisions to deal with it, but it's most likely, it will most likely become a problem soon enough. The hell are you going? Well, at least you are redeploying. In a weird way, but that's mostly because this attack, they couldn't redeploy through this. Removing that, since they're in the mountain, would take a while. Let's take a look at this, because this is more important. Could have been better. Definitely don't want you to do that. And you should definitely defend this. How about grab some coastline? This is working rather poorly. How about we encircle you? Okay. You need to first cancel the attack and then order them to do another, because, well, if that's not going to happen, that will force them to retreat, and if someone will show up there, we will lose that division. That would be bad. Okay, but this whole thing seems very, very undefended. This is kind of a mess. Well, now we don't really have a lot of troops left here, but hopefully, I basically didn't think that we'll be able to break through their resistance fast enough, and that we'll have all those units here to support us. I guess that's not the case. And for that reason, we are now going to add a few more units. Yeah. Okay, let's just make sure that all of the units that are redeployed from here are the ones we explicitly told to do that. It seems like it. What's this defense? We've been pushed back. I wish there was an information of what, how many, well, about losses basically. We have insufficient resources, aluminum. Let's grab some, shall we? Oh man. It's bad and it will be worse. It will be so much worse. I guess we'll get some from France and some from Romania. How much are we missing anyway? 13, well, we'll be missing more of it as soon as those lines with support equipment and lines with fighters will continue, and we are missing oil. And look at that, surplus zero of rubber. Oil, we can, well, Iran will get its Iranian oil soon enough. Let's get some from the US for the time being. Alright, and we were supposed to start justifying. Okay, we need to actually justify on. What? We have. Where? And I don't remember signing an Christian bloody pact with them. How about France? Where the fuck I signed a non-aggression pact? Why would I do that? Damn it. Huh. Well, I guess we have to wait half a year. Okay, perhaps if we get our forces on the border with British Raj, that would help. Or if they... Okay, are you guaranteeing someone? Netherlands, Greece and Denmark. Okay, that's not helpful. We actually have an aggression pact with Greece. I was very silly at some point in this game. Huh. Alright, Mongolia, I want you to give me... Actually, you don't have a control of that, it just looks this way. Okay, so that will be back in our control soon enough. And we are almost alright with supplies. What else? Frankly, I want all of you to be unassigned from this division, and I want you to... One should be here. One should be here. One should be here. One should be here, and we'll just do the land grab since there are no defenders. Right, and this should die at some point. We got an ace, cool. I really need to start working on Intel. Out of many other things I need to start working on. We'll leave them for the time being. Actually, we can just assign them to this thing. Okay, yeah. And let's continue grabbing the territory. Okay. Here you go. Very nice. This, sure. Okay, oh, so you are part of this group, aren't you? You aren't? Oh, alright. Let's do that. I know this attack through the river is kind of pointless, but let's just continue to moving them through. Through it would take too long. Alright, so it seems like we... Not sure what... Why is Japan the controller on this? Oh, right, because this is the whole thing. And this is the reason I imagine why we cannot, since we are not controlling the whole thing, we cannot use this. Or we need to... Not... Well, that would make sense, I guess. Okay, let's take a look at the air war. What is the closest one using empty and using allies? Beijing. Do we have spare planes? Well, of course, do not have spare planes. We do have spare planes here. Let's take six of you and send you to Beijing, shall we? would be even almost able to reach. And then once we get access to this airfield, we shall move you there, and that will facilitate our conquest nicely. Okay, this is coming along nicely. Of course, we'll need I guess we don't really need that, do we? Have we gotten any airfields around here? Of course not. Why would we? And I guess you can. Sure. That will help. Sort of, I guess. Perfectly, you cover 20% of the region. Sure. Would have done that, that done nothing. There are thousands Japanese planes here. So let's not kick the hornet's nest just yet. And our allies are, of course, busy guarding borders that don't need guarding. Have they actually, like, fought anything? Not really. Like, some of them tripped, apparently. I really don't like that your allies are so passive. I guess the developers figured that they will just give you the option of using the expeditionary force and didn't bother to like properly program the allied AI, but I don't know, I don't like it at all. One more look at okay, so we are starting to suffer some resistance. Should be alright. In a few episodes, we should be able to break through all of that. And okay, speaking of breaking through, okay, so this is not working very well. So yeah, it will not be as easy as it sounds to make this nice and settlement up there. On the other hand, getting this victory point seems like a good idea. And let's order our tanks to keep moving. Okay. Oh, there's a mud showing up in August, so I guess that's mostly due to rain, as it is. We are right with that. Love if you guys like took all those information into consideration when deciding which way to move. Okay, that's kind of like more or less covered, so we'll deal with the rest of it later. And I think that's enough for this episode, because I got a preview code for EU4. Well, by the now you By the time you watch it, you will know that, because there will be a few episodes, but I need to record those, because I only had time to play like a small test game, and the embargo for Let's Plays is lifted in like 6 hours or so. So I need to do some more testing and at least try to record something, because, well, I'm also leaving for a weekend, so I need to record everything now for a few days. Will take a bloody while. So, thanks for watching once again, guys, and see you next time.